I mean, apart from religion, apart from history, if you go through the history or the things people have done in various countries, you'll find some teenagers that have actually excelled, and not just in education, in various areas of life. And we want to let these young people know that what others have done at their age, they too they can do. We've also found people, young people that were reaching out in their earlier years, the teacher, their parents, and their guardians wrote them off, but they woke up. And as they woke up, they actually did something not just important for themselves, but for their nations. So once you tell these young people, no matter where they have been or what they have not been able to do, they can take this week as the beginning of their future. And things can turn around in their lives and also in the lives of, you know, people around them.
Two more questions.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Hold on.
So we look at the youths and then we see so many of them, and then we see elderly ones that are going or have learned so much. Now, looking at this program, sir, what are going to be the practical things that will be done here that will so touch the young people to draw from you and draw from so many rivers that in 10 years' time, in 20 years' time, this river will keep flowing? Then righteousness continues, because we see the rate of ungodliness that is sweeping, sometimes not by our own fault as young people, but because of the influence that we get around us.
Okay. Generally, we will not be the first set of people to have a program like this. I will not be the first. There are different results of such a program like this. One, it could be emotional, it could be sensational, it could be the euphoria of gathering together with, you know, other young people, and they just enjoy themselves for this period, which would be like we have succeeded in entertaining them. But that is not my own vision or my desire. My desire is to, even though I'm speaking to the crowd of young people, I want each of these young people to think and to feel I'm talking to him in particular. And I'm having dialogue with him, and I'm asking him now, what has brought you to where you are? If you continue the way you have always been, where will the road lead you? I want to set them thinking. And as they think, I want them to understand the principle on which they are working or basing their lives can change. Once the principle changes, and I'm not thinking I'm a product of my country, a product of my teachers did not, you know, teach well, and then I put all the blame of my failure on other people, I want each one to begin to look at themselves as, if I'm a failure, it's not much of what others have done to me, it's what I've done to myself. Once they begin to see that, then we can say, okay, what principles will lead me to the life I ought to live for my own good, for my own happiness, and for the growth of my community, so that I make a mark and impact in the world in which I'm placed. Once they get the point that it is principle that matters, not just the emotional, the joy and all that, which all that is good for young people, but then they have a principle. If you have a principle, what do you practice? What do you see yourself becoming? Once they see that and they follow that principle with practical tips, I believe that 10 years to come, 20 years to come, in Jesus Christ, they will be in the place where they are dreaming. Of course, you know, if we look at people like Abraham Lincoln, who is now at present rated as one of the best presidents that had ever been in America. He failed a number of times, but he had a principle, he had a goal. Because of that goal and that practice, that's how he became what he eventually became. So We want to engage the young people one-on-one, even though we're talking to the crowd, that this is what you can be, and that the grace of God, I believe, they will rise up and they have a future, and that future will be fulfilled. Yes.
Last
okay.
question.
Good evening, sir. My name is Robert Tigby from The Nation newspaper. The quality of speakers at this event is truly very, very rich. Most people have acknowledged that. But some have also expressed concern about the kinds of speakers. About some of the speakers, as a matter of fact. They have expressed reservations such as whether the church is lowering its standards, its very high standards that it's traditionally known for. So they have expressed surprise. So how can you reassure them that they have no cause for alarm?
I think it depends on what you are looking at. If you are looking at just something religious or something just deeper life, you'll go this direction. But if you're looking at people who are made it in life and who have made it in life, not just money, not just popularity, not just fame. There are people that have reputation but they don't have character. Other people have character and they are not well known. Let's say for example, I need a chemistry teacher to teach some young people. I'll not be looking at, you see a member of Deeper Life, you see not a member of Deeper Life, does he agree with me and dot every I and cross every T for me? I'll be looking at somebody who knows the subject, who knows the students, who knows how to connect with those young people and who can impact them and make them to love that subject and even become, give them tips that will make them become greater than himself in that field. That's what I'll be looking at. Other, the people who might say that, you know, learning standard and all that, number one, they do not know the caliber of people who are invited. Then they judge them on their own little understanding of, you know, who these people are. And some of them have not even taken the effort to go to, you know, if you go on the web, on the internet, you can check up their profile and see who they are. Maybe they just saw their picture and they said, okay, this is not my kind of person. And because of that, they think we are compromising. You know, in a country with freedom of speech, they are allowed to say what they say. The unfortunate thing is that some people say, I want to say my mind, but their mind is not well developed. And they wasted the time of the people that even listen to them when they want to speak their mind. But rather than being angry with them, we pity them and we would love them to come to, you know, such a place like this and see the product of what is coming out of what we're doing.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pastor.
That's all.
Yeah.
So, no.
God bless everyone.
Good bless you, sir.
I think we also need to know this, that this convocation is not religious in quotes. It's not to, we want people to believe in Christ. We want people to, you know, to be Christians, but it's for everyone. In my earlier years, when I taught mathematics, I had Muslim students, I had Christian students, I had, you know, those who are neither Christian nor Muslim. But when I taught them, I didn't teach them with, okay, this one is a Christian, I'm going to teach him very well. This one is a Muslim, I'll teach, but not like I would normally. This one is a non-religious fellow. Here, we want to see them as citizens of the world, as citizens of our country. And how can we help everyone that comes across to be their best for themselves, for their families, for our country, and for the world? So as we push this out, let's understand that this is just to help everyone, religious or not religious, who want to impact the lives of the citizens of our country, and of course of people. And we will get this on.
Yes, sir. It's a global one, yeah.
You will be to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Sorry, I wouldn't know if I can have in.
No,
Yoruba.
He's a Yoruba. Okay.
People will have to
hear it.
No. Let him have it now.
Do that.
What station are you from? Bond FM.
What do you mean by the most popular? It's not more popular than any other ghost. I beg.
And basically, you want to give back for a be one at a full relay.
God bless you, sir.
Let's
pray.
Father, we do thank you for our brothers and sisters. Thank you for the great work you've given them to do.
Thank you,
Lord, for their personal lives and their families. This is a new year. And as we pass Happy New Year and out, I pray that in reality, Happy New Year will be for them in Jesus.
Amen.
All their concerns and desires for themselves, their parents, their children, everyone, I pray that you fulfill in their lives in Jesus.
Amen.
A great impact from heaven upon them.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor.
All
right, I guess this interview just clarifies why we have different speakers in this Impact program. And it's not really a religious one like what the Pastor W.F. Kumi has just said, but a non-denominational one to impact all lives across the board. So, it's Impact 2022. If you're not in this program, you should just connect wherever you are this time.
Arrange yourself. How you like it.